entering the Amalfi Coast.
Just arrived here. Beautiful sunny day. I'm really happy to be here.
Exactly. I'm super
excited. Always great memories.
Exactly. Kat is with us.
Hello.
She's having her first Amalfi Coast experience.
It's a good way to put it. It truly is an experience.
Yeah, definitely.
The nice driver, please.
Oh, yes. Angela.
The nice driver.
Of course.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow. Every time. This is my fifth time here. Every time. Crazy. I had a little teary moment.
I remember the first time we arrived here, we were on a bus. It was Layla and I, Alex and Layla's ex-boyfriend. And one moment I just looked at the scenery and I realized I had tears in my face and I was like, what's going on? I don't understand.
Yeah.
But really, like, the view just like takes your breath away. It's crazy. So beautiful.
Wow. Let's begin.
Is that our favorite place, Casa Ibotega?
Yeah.
The food is amazing here. Yes. Filming all the food. It's the best. It's just the quality of the ingredients is so amazing and it just makes all the difference in the world. This is what I crave the most. Local and seasonal veggies and fruit. The grapes are in season now too. Okay, we're gonna get a whole bunch of things now. And the figs. Oh. My favorite. Have you tried a fig? Let me know in the comment down below. You can travis it. You can travis it. We have some plums.
Did you try the grapes?
I tried the grapes. And peaches. And if you smell it, it actually smells like a peach. So good. We met this lady here earlier. She was Italian. We just started chatting with her. And she was saying how, you know, one of the most important things when you're buying fruits or veggies is like when you pick up the fruit or veggie, it has to smell. If it doesn't smell, then it's not good. They're lucky to have fresh produce here. I mean, if you live in a big city, it's not always possible. Yeah.
like from my grandma's garden back in the day.
My favorite thing in Positano is just watching the sunset.
Yeah. Well, there's no direct sunset.
There's no direct sunset. If you look over there, the sun kind of sets behind the mountain now because it's already a different time of the year. But it's just like just sitting here.
Experience.
And seeing the day slowly get darker. Saying goodbye to the beautiful sun.
It's still sunny there.
Oh yeah, it's true. Something magical about this place.
So nice. I can never get sick of this view.
It's amazing. So tiny.
Oh, look at him.
He sees the kid and he still wants to play.
He wants to play. He's so cute. He's so cute. He's so cute.
And the stair games begin. Hey, kitty. Kitty's coming with us. I don't want to show you my toes because I lost one. And the other one is about to go. So it ain't pretty, but I'll show you the view instead. Cat is flipping out.
I can't stop filming.
Yeah, we're gonna have a lot of footage. And more stairs. Let's go. Come on, Cat, you can do it.
Yeah, it'll be a lot of...
By the end of this trip, we're gonna have legs that are rock solid. Yes, Alex? More to go. Just look at this view. It's just like a painting. Oh my God! I can't believe this is real. It's like we've been here how many times? And every time, it feels magical.
Life stands still in Positano. I made my homes in my own place. I got no room for no man. That's my way. That's my way. But then I saw you.
It's the best view of Positano here. Like right in front of your face. But I don't need space from you. In every single thing you do, I like. So many temptations. But I think I'm gonna pass. No man, that's my way. That's my
way. Best breakfast ever. Where they had almond milk cappuccino. It's one thing I drink and make sure that I get once when I come to Italy. Because I really don't have caffeine, but with almond milk, it's just the perfect thing to start the morning with. But only in Italy. I can't name. I can't name.
It's strange. You get to see all the beautiful colored houses and of course the iconic church with beautiful tiles on the roof. It was worth coming. I had to beg this guy to come here for breakfast. Literally beg him. He's like, oh, I don't know.
Usually I don't like
so overpriced.
I don't splurge on breakfast. Because usually breakfast to me is like.
But you're not just paying for the breakfast, which by the way was amazing.
But I'll tell you this.
You're paying for the
view.
I think
this place was the first place was actually worth it.
Yeah, and then of course the view. I mean, it's just spectacular from here. I could be faded with somebody new. Rather be sober at home, just us two.
I made my own. It's my friend. Because last
petting her too.
Oh, we're calling each other. We're calling each other. Oh, she loves you.
I love you so much, winter bomb. Favorite little restaurant. It's called the Adolfo, and a little boat with the sign of the little fish,
red fish.
Comes and picks you up right here at the port. I think these people are all lining up for the boat.
Last time there was like a big fight. We got it.
Yeah, but it's really cute. It's only like 10-minute boat ride from Positano.
Landing.
I'm just hanging out here on the rocks and watching this beautiful scenery. The massive waves crushing into these rocks. It's just very, very peaceful here. It's sort of recharging. No cars, not a lot of people, just nature. I'm so grateful for this moment.
Look, it was very tough deciding. What do we get?
Lots of delicious things.
we're going all out. Like if we're coming here once, we gotta go all out.
Meet me and Luke Skywalker.
Who's favorite? Lemon.
I've been waiting all year for this.
It is good.
It is good. It's very different.
Yeah, we got sat with our new friends, John and Miriam.
Hello.
Raleigh. You gave me such good confidence at the beginning. She's like, and Raleigh's like,
you got cocky.
I got cocky. My head got big.
And now you ruined it.
Amazing. Like you guys know, I don't do dairy, but when I'm in Italy, apparently I do.
It's worth it. Oh, taste camp. She was the daughter of the God. Alright, so we just arrived at this monastery apparently that was converted into a hotel.
Yeah. So I guess monks.
Alex is surprising us. Let's see what this place is all about. I really love that.
It's 1925.
Yeah. Funny. Dated as 1925. And we're in Amalfi right now, right?
Yes, yeah,
at the top of Amalfi.
We actually wanted to go to Ravello tonight. And what happened was the waves were so big that the ferries weren't going so. So we're here.
Alright, let's go check it out. Fancy place, Alex.
Yeah, it's a nice place to get a massage.
Not a bad place to get a massage. I wouldn't mind so. Alright, let's find this. Apparently the most beautiful infinity pool, or probably just the only infinity pool in Positano, because I don't think they have infinity pools here because there's not a lot of space. This is so pretty. What's here? Wow. Oh my god, that is crazy. Look at that boat too. There's some humans on that boat, some people. How crazy is that? Olive tree with lots of olives. Not sure if you can see it, but there's plenty of them. And here are the olives. When we were little, my sister and I, we used to collect olives, and my mom, and then she would marinate them. They were delicious. Good morning! It's our last day in Positano. Hi, Alex. And we're gonna make the best of today. We're gonna go for breakfast right now, then we're gonna do a hike at the Path of Gods without any guide. Yes, Alex?
I'll be your guide today.
That's gonna be interesting. That's a really beautiful hike that we did a couple of days ago.
Years.
It's a beautiful hike that we did 2 years ago, that when we were here in Positano, but we did it with a guide. It's really not that complicated. I think we'll be able to figure it out.
Yeah.
But anyways, I really wanted to quick film me to show you guys the bed and breakfast where we're staying.
It's like the room is messy.
It's a bit messy, but I think you guys will forgive us. Don't close the door, Alex. For a long time, I was like, oh, I don't know if I should share this place, because we come to Positano every year. And I want to make sure that when we come here, we have a room to stay, because it's really not that big of a place. I think she has about 10-20 rooms. I'm not really sure, but it's really the best deal in town, I think. I mean, the first time we came to Positano, we stayed all the way up on the mountain. You can't even see it right now because it's covered by the clouds. It's called Nocelli. It's a really beautiful village. However, if you're coming to Positano, I definitely suggest staying here, because you want to be close to the beach, you want to be close to everything that's around the city.
And not pay a lot.
And not pay like a ton of money, because the
hotels are like 800 euros.
Yeah, the hotels are super expensive here. So anyways, I'm going to quickly show you this cute little room. It's really simple, but it's all you need here, because we literally just come to sleep, right?
Yeah, and but the view.
But the best part is the view. Yeah, like, oh my god, look at this. It's just dreamy. This is definitely one of the best views of Positano, and this bed and breakfast is an amazing deal. And it's called Casa Cosenza. I love you guys, and I want you to have the same kind of experience.
And we're saying this the room, but the terrace room is my favorite.
Yeah, it was just booked this time because we obviously, like always, plan everything last minute. So we got this room, which is really nice. Again, I'll quickly show you.
This is basically the bed. Alex did the best job at making it nice. What else? Have a little bench, our luggage, little desk if you want to do a bit of work or anything else. The view, and then you have a little place where you can do makeup. Hello. Hi guys. And then the closet, of course. I'll show you the inside. It's so beautiful, like even look at the doors, they're so cute. So yeah, just the closet is quite big. And yeah, you have a mini fridge. And the best part is you wake up to this view. Oh wait, I don't know if I should show the washroom. No, quickly show it. It's nothing special, but it's clean, that's all that matters. It's nice and clean. But I think the best part of this place is Josephine, the owner of the place.
Yeah, she's really nice.
She's gonna freak out if she knows we featured her.
She's like our aunt.
Yeah, when we come here, she like gives us a hug and she's like, Alex, Mimi, bonjour.
Yeah, so if you guys visit, you have to be very nice to her. Because we have some friends visit and they're being a little, you know.
Drama queens.
Like, you know, it's Europe. Get used to it. Things are smaller. It's fine. And the water is different, you know, when it says sea, it's not cold, it's hot.
You mean in the shower?
In the shower, yeah. So, because some people confuse the water, it's sea is hot, and then F is cold.
Anyways, yeah, Josephine is amazing, she's like family now. This is what real lemons look like. They're all perfect in their own imperfect way.
Waiting for the bus. With lots of people. So yeah, we'll see if we get on the bus.
In Italy, you just never know.
And if the bus will come or not.
Mamma mia, so many people.
Huh? Holy. We should have stood on the other line. Hey. So we didn't make the first bus.
Gotta wait for the next one now.
It's bus madness both ways. There's two buses. I don't know if we'll get on, so we'll see. Yeah.
It's hot and humid.
We've been waiting for like a good 45 minutes now, probably.
At least.
Yeah. Oh, this one left. So we got on the bus.
I guess we're meant to go on this hike.
In the midday, so we'll see what happens. It's gonna be very interesting. I'll definitely take off my shirt. So it's an hour after. The bus ride was very long. It is now noon. We started at, I think, 10, 10-ish, 10-15. The plan was supposed to be there 11 latest. So we're running. We're gonna be in the peak time. It'll be very interesting. Very exciting.
All we gotta do is just get there.
So it's our first bus stop. We have to change the buses and go up.
You know how long now the bus is?
We'll see. I don't know, because this bus that we took right now was supposed to be 25 minutes, but I think it was a full out hour. So yeah, we'll see. It's very exciting, very humid. Keep you posted.
So. Yeah, we just decided to take another bus to Amalfi after waiting for about...
We waited 45 minutes on this corner right here.
At least 45 minutes, but the bus didn't come, so we're just gonna be spontaneous and go to Amalfi instead.
Yeah, we're gonna go to Amalfi.
Actually, I don't think we've ever been to Amalfi.
We always gone to Amalfi and then just gone to Ravello. And it's really hot.
It's really, really hot, so I think actually it wouldn't be a great
Because it's midday. Okay. I really want Kat to live.
Thank you.
So, oh, nice view.
Yeah, I don't mind taking the bus with this kind of view.
That's alright.
It's pretty epic.
So we'll see you. Next adventure awaits. we finally made it to Amalfi.
I'm just happy I wore my up shoulder top because the magical trick here is that you can wear it like that, and if it gets too hot, you can just do this.
Exactly. Oh, it's so dark.
The small things make me happy.
Exactly. Yeah, but it's been lots of traffic today. Ooh, this is nice. Oh, look, there's a wedding too.
Oh, look how beautiful. Wow, and the bride in white. Check out the bride.
Cool, we actually never been here, so. No boats, so we have to take the bus.
Another 3 hours to go back.
You never know, maybe it's shorter.
Hopefully it's not as bad as it was in the morning. Nocelli, so it's this place all the way at the top.
Way
of
up, you can't even see it.
Yeah, you can't even see it because it's that high, and it's 1750 steps to go up there. But I'm very excited. It's a great exercise. It's a beautiful view up there.
Exactly, but I love this view, like behind this. I call it the Italian Eiffel Tower. That's what represents Italy.
We're matching.
Are we?
Yeah.
Oh, cute. You have a white too? Oh no, I didn't have white. I should have worn white.
Almost matched.
Alright, let's go.
Let's go. We gotta catch the sunset. We haven't even gotten to the hike point, and I think we already took 715 steps.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Just getting to the hike is quite a walk, but it's a beautiful scenic walk. If you're scared of heights, you might be scared of this. Oh, nevertheless, amazing. This is it. Here comes the 1750 steps.
We already 1750. Did like 700.
Yeah, I think we already did 1700 steps just getting here. But like
yeah,
I like to say,
we came from there. You can see.
Yeah, we came from all the way there. But like I like to say, there's no elevator to success. You gotta take the stairs, so always take the stairs. Not only will it make you physically fit, it will make your mind really fit, and then you will be able to accomplish anything in life, anything you set your mind to. Now, let the stairs begin. It's actually not that hard, probably in a cooler weather, but when it's super humid like it is today and hot, it's like double the work.
It's easy.
It's easy, yes, yes, it's easy. The best part about this hike is that the higher you get, the better views you get as well. Whew. Oh, my heart is panting, but we gotta keep going. Gotta keep going up. I don't know where Kat is, we lost her. Kat! Kat, are you there? We're waiting for you. Wow. Whew.
It's starting to rain.
It's starting to rain. Still 35, 40 minutes to go. The sky is beautiful and dramatic. Look at the view there. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep going up.
They didn't say anything about the rain.
I know. It's definitely drizzling. Actually, I find it kind of refreshing. All right, you can see the raindrops. Oh, it's a summer rain. It's good for the soul. Let's go. Let's keep moving. I think somebody was eating the cactus fruit here. These flowers bring back so many memories.
I don't know what they're called in English, but in Russian they're called Nachnaya Krasavitsa, which means night beauty, because they only blossom at night, and during the day they close up, and night they come up. As you can see, they're just opening up as it's getting darker. We had them at our cottage house.
What is that?
Thunderstorm. It's quite scary actually to be up here unprotected. Let it rain, let it rain.
Cat, where are you?
Cat is a superstar.
Let's do it. Almost there.
It started raining, so we're just hiding from the rain. Hello, red face. Sweaty after the hike. Wow.
Oh, wow. What?
Oh, wow.
We did not expect
this. It's like the praise for getting up here.
I think it's gonna get less humid though.
We have made it! Woohoo! High five! Good job!
High five!
Amazing.
It wasn't, yeah, it was,
yeah, it wasn't that bad.